Hello, welcome to Atom RPG, and this is the best quest in the game with the highest reward, the easiest money made, and also the highest payment for a quest in rubles. Well, it's not exactly what you expect, but I'll give you a few hints. It involves the mafia. So, you can speak to all these guys, but only he will answer to you. And this is basically White Mike Tyson. I just wanted to say hello to you. Do you know me? Called Shish Kebab? Their mouths with their hands and shake? No. Shishak? Nope. They don't remember him either. So these guys are basically the mafia, but they got tired of robbing caravans. Because after they robbed the caravan, they had to lay low for a long, long while, and well, that's not very profitable. So they just lend money to people who want to gamble or have some problems, and then they take it back 2 or 3 times with an interest of 200%, 300%, yeah. So now he's telling me from where to get the money. By the way, don't do this. If you have enough money, you can actually repay their debts back, so don't do it. As you can see, we have 3 quests, because it's split into 3 parts. And now let's go to the first person who has our money. Because it will be our money, not theirs. Oh, actually, no, stop. The first person is on the boat. So, the first person is basically the person playing the slot machine in the casino, or the bar. And let's talk about your debts. You need to have very high speechcraft, but if you have high enough intelligence, you can convince him. I'm absolutely sure you should give me the money and don't try to win double at the slot machine. Oh, he pledged his rifle, his country house, everything. I don't think you'll win it back from the machines. Oh well, your choice, buddy. That's why gambling is bad. You never make what you lose. Or if you want to do it for the experience or for the thrill of it, hey, go ahead. That's 5,000 rubles we just got. And we're about to get a lot more back. Now, again, from what I read, because I'll make a short break here. I have to read about 5, 10 minutes, 20 minutes of online gaming and maybe watch a few videos just to figure out how a quest works. Because I don't really have time to do a quest 2 times or 3 times. Okay, I needed to talk to you and you need to pay back your debt. Hello. For 60 days. In a year, his pathetic 1,000. Not now. What? Then, when do you want to pay him back? The business lady gives you her money. Okay. Thank you for your cooperation. That's almost funny and sad at the same time. So she wanted to do a little business or something like that before she left the city, but no. You have to give money back. Don't ever borrow money. Well, if you borrow from the bank, borrow it on a long period of time, because even if you pay a lot of money, it will be a small sum, so it won't bother you that much. But if you borrow a lot of money and you can't pay the rates or the interest, that's not good. Try to make a sum that you can manage. So again, let's get back to the game, because the game is the most important thing right now. Okay, as you can see, he's basically finished. The second person is in the coal factory. He's in the power facility. Yeah, in the power plant. and he's the guy that's responsible for the call. I actually think I have a quest to do for him, but I need to get into the basement of the facility. I think this is the guy. Your debt. He's working in this village to cover his debts and also make a little money to send to his family. You see, I owe money to other people as well. No, these people are dangerous. Give me all your money now. Okay. 3,000 rubles. He didn't have such a big amount to give us. Now, here is where things get tough. I mean, we basically have 15,000 rubles. From what I understand, I'll just make this a save on the fourth slot. From what I understand, if you give back the money, you'll get only 1,000 rubles back as a payment or as a reward. But if you keep all the money, they'll just execute the people because they didn't pay the money. So the game will just think you failed to get the money back, and they will kill all of them, which is extremely bad for them and for gameplay reasons. But at the same time, you can keep all this money from what I know, and you'll still finish the quest, but you'll finish it without a reward and you'll still advance it. I don't think they changed this because I read on the forum all the changes of the game and that's not mentioned. So, whatever works for me. As you can see, this trader has not changed his stock. Well, that's another cuirass, another plate armor. I almost want to buy it. Okay, but first let's see what weapons do they have. Before we do anything stupid. Oh, wait a second. I just remember something. I can actually sell to this guy because his prices are better than the last one. 300 rubles is not that small of a sum. And he still has a lot of money left, so let's sell him all this excess junk. I don't know why this is so expensive, the hunting rifle. Well, maybe it's because it uses the 545 ammo, which is very, very common in the game. And not the more expensive one. Well, okay, give me 1,000 rubles. And now I'm very light. I'll have to think about that armor. I don't think it's worth it, but then again, maybe I'll just find some enemies who are wearing it. But on the other side, I should start thinking about armor piercing rounds, because that armor is fantastic. That means I'll only do a little damage to them. Oh well, okay, let me show you what happens if you turn in the quest. Because I want to show you the good thing and the bad thing, and again, if you really like role-playing the game, you can just give them the money back. But if you don't like role-playing the game and you want to keep the money, you can keep the money, because they're mafia gangsters. They don't have any clear way of getting the money back. They just can't go to the authorities or hire mercenaries like we can do. Okay, let me show you what happens if you give him the money. Okay, peaceful method of money collecting. Bloody Valera. So, how much money did I lose? Okay, 9,000. Okay, so the 1,500 rubles they let me keep. Okay, Shishak. And then he'll give you the next quest. In his room on the this room. And I'll advance the quest to this guy. And you can attack them and get a lot more rewards out of them and a lot of better stuff. Or you can just do their quest and then attack them. Yeah, because they're his accomplices. So if you steal from them, it's a double win and a double situation because they already stole from Dan, and Dan is a decent enough guy to ignore for a little while. And you know, I just showed you how to do it, what happens and what... Now let me show you what you can buy with that money. Oh yes, this is a lot better than I thought I would be. Maybe I can buy the RPK-74. Well, this is actually a good idea. By the way, let me show you how to pass time the real way. It will cost you a lot of money, but... Okay, let's do it the old way. You can sleep at the hotel, which is right here. And they'll also feed you, so if you don't mind wasting a few hundred rubles, that's okay. But if you're a cheapskate... Then you'll wait here and eat something. But it's a lot of food and, well, you're just wasting it. So in the end you don't gain anything by doing this the cheap way, you just lose more money by eating a lot of food. Well, using the hotel also is kind of bad because you sleep sometimes for 10 hours or less, depending on what time you get in. So now it's 20 PM. And now it's not morning, it's 4 PM. So that's 8 hours of sleep. Which is not a lot, but let's check out the gunsmith, the gun shop. And as I said, the only thing you'll be losing if you don't give back the money is that those NPCs will be dead. And if they are dead, well, it's bad for you. But I think it will be manageable. Wow, I need so much food. Sometimes I think food is the most important resource in this game. Money. What's money? You can't eat money, right? Money is basically for free in this game. There are some crazy quests. So this quest with a quest that will give you 2 SKS or something crazy like that. If you combine these two quests, they are the best in the game. If you look at the reward. But this one is a lot later in the game. And at this point of the game... Okay, let's see what they have. Oh, they added an AKMS. Oh, that's nice. This is really nice. So 10 to 21, that will be 30 to 63, that's crazy damage. 19, cool. I'm thinking, this gun will use up a lot of ammo, but this gun will do a lot more damage. I don't know, let's see how this one works. Okay, you can have my money, I just want to test it out. So basically this is the most expensive gun you can buy at this guy, from what I know. And let's see how it's working. It looks very cool for once, even though it's clipping with my armor. What's a short burst? Six bullets for a short burst? Yikes. Okay, that's a lot of damage and a lot of ammo. 12 bullets. Hey, come back. Give me your ammo, not your hexogen. Fidel. I guess I need to some way of distinguishing between them. So I'm just testing how good this rifle actually is, this automatic gun, this light machine gun. So again. That's 15 bullets. That's well over 100 damage. This gun is overkill. Maybe if you fight a boss, this one is worth it, but if it's not something big, it will just waste a lot of your ammo and your hard-earned money, because, well, ammunition is very, very expensive in this game compared to the prices of the weapon. So I don't know, maybe this is not cost-effective enough to use. Yeah, it's not good enough for me. Maybe later in the game when we'll actually have some worse things to kill. But for right now, I think I'll want the AKMS. Besides, their ammunition is so expensive, you'll likely run out of cash. That weapon is endgame, is a endgame weapon, and you probably can use it later when you have the car and you have no money problems. Okay, why not? Let's wait. And we'll actually use some of our food. A little bit, not all. Oh, come on, can't you wait another one? Another... Fine. You are very hungry. Okay, let's try to save some money, because this is the save we'll keep. So just go to the merchants and see if you can buy some food. Some cheap, healthy, good food. Okay, so he sells fruits. And that's not very nutritious. You can't eat raw corn, so let's move on. Okay, so I'm testing this because if you get the money and you decide to keep it, I want to show you what you could get and how to better use your strategy. Onion is pretty good, but not exactly food material. So this guy has the best... That scared me. That little critter is adorable. This guy has the best food almost. 600 food and, well, some barter points. I'll just buy one. Oh! Now I buy one. And that was 63. Oh. I forgot about that, okay. Okay, this is a lot better now. That's 8 rubles, that's 15. Why? Why is the corned one? Never mind. Don't ask. Probably because you can feed the raw meat to the dog and you can heal him that way. So it's better? I don't understand that system anyway. So now let's decide what weapon we want to use. I guess the AKMS is the best one. Because as I said, you need a more flexible weapon. That light machine gun is an end game weapon. And it uses a lot of bullets and it can be very good right now, but as I said, you might want to wait a little bit before you get that weapon, because the ammunition it uses may be a little too much for you now. Besides, as I said, you need to keep your money to upgrade your house to get the car and do all those things. So have a little priorities. These weapons are perfectly serviceable for what I need now. Oh, I hate all this menu and the menu foo. And by that I mean menu, kung fu, navigation and learning its ancient mysteries and treats. I treat well, you give me... Oh, this is another weapon. You may think this is a very good weapon because it does a lot of damage, but it has the close range penalty. It has mid range and it also uses the 7.62x54 ammunition. Let me show you the difference. This is 11. This is 8. And this is 29. See the difference? Yeah, that difference is too big to not take into consideration. Okay, let's eat something before we do this. Unfortunately, this is the way you are supposed to do it. I don't know, I don't like the mechanic either, but hey. What can we do in this situation? Just wait and see what happens. We'll see what weapon do you get. And eat more meat. Okay, let's save right now. Oh, come on, I'm so close to it. Let's quick save again and wait for 3 hours and let's see what he has for us. I already have a Vintores and ammo for this gun is even more expensive. 29. So try to stay away from those endgame weapons which cost a lot of rubles to use. Just go for a basic model until you have done all the other things and you don't need the money. Ouch, so this tactic doesn't work. Okay, let's try it another way. So if we wait this amount of time, it's preset. Let's go to 12. Yeah, I have a feeling this won't be better than the other one. Okay, so I guess we have to wait another cycle. Oh, this will be so much fun, right? Okay, let's save again. Basically, I'm doing this just to show you and just to learn more from the game. So this is what they have today. Let's see what happens in 12 hours. After I eat something, of course, because I don't want to starve, right? Now, did I eat all my canned meat? Huh, maybe I did. Okay, a little more. Still the same weapons, I don't understand this. And when did I save the last time in here? I think it was this one. Game number 2. So let's see. That could be decent, but again, I don't really want to use that. Okay, so that will be 12 hours, so maybe I didn't wait enough. Okay, I'll go and buy some more food. I'm not cheap like that. I'll just go and buy more food for me. Let's see what else do they have in the shop. This will be a longer video, and again, this is not why I'm showing you this thing. I'm showing you these things because you can get this quest, well, not early, because you don't want to waste a lot of time walking around and not doing the other stuff, like the quest or the combat. So this is basically something to help you choose a weapon for yourself and your... for your fellow stalkers, or whatever they're called now. So just buy the cord meat and go back to the line. Okay, let's eat something before we do that. That was just 100 rubles, so you don't waste a lot of money by doing this. And as I said, I just want to show you some of the possibilities. I hope we get the AKMS next. Come on, where are you? This bug can happen. Just quick save and quick log. Sometimes it won't let you go in his little shop. See? Okay, this time let's save before we start to pass the time. So in this day they should change their inventory. What do you have for me now? Oh, the AKS-47 oh, and the Dragunov. Are you kidding me now? Of course I won't get the anything else but the Dragunov. But I still... Oh, so tempting, so tempting. This weapon does crazy damage, crazy amounts of damage. Oh well, I guess I'll buy it because it doesn't really matter. If I find something too big to kill, that's my fault. I'll just switch them around a bit. And it's not very heavy, it's just 4.5 kilograms. But that plus to critical, that's amazing. Critical chance plus 15%. Whew. Okay, let's buy it. Well, I might want to buy some ammunition for it as well. Because we have so much money, right? Okay, what else do I need to buy? I think I have enough, but I'll just buy 10 more. And let's say 20 more of those. Yeah, this should be enough for now. And this automatic pistol does so much damage, it can burst damage anything almost. Actually, I'm happy with my decisions for now. I hope. Let's switch to the Mighty Dragunov. This will be like a permanent debuff to our damage, but again, this gun does so much damage. I mean, look at it compared to this case, 11, 19, 16 to 27, and also, these bullets have so much armor piercing possibility, 53%, and that's 48. Well, the difference is not so big as I thought it will be. But remember, you'll want to kill the bigger enemies with this one and the weakest with the other one. Now, as you can see, my rifles and shotgun will be 101, just to mess with you. And this will be a keeper. So this is just another video showing you how to do a quest and also to increase your firepower. Basically, you can buy better weapons for your whole team, and you can also buy better armors for your whole team. But it's better if you wait and get your barter up to 101 before you buy anything with this money. And it's also better that you do all the quests in the other areas, because as I said, you don't want to do a lot of backtracking in this game, because that can kill you, that can really annoy you. This has been a very productive video, at least for me. Besides, this rifle is scoped. So you'll get the bonus critical chance from scoped firearms, which will be my next skill. Well, when I level up, because hey, I wanted more skill points. And also 10% discount everywhere, so this is why prices may vary. So with 101 barter, the discount skill, the discount check passed, and also that 10% discount everywhere, you can buy them from the gunsmith. If not, it'll take you a very long time to get. I just want to show you how long this weapon is. Come on. Oh, the light is so bad in here. Yeah, that's better. Okay. See you next time. Bye.